Hey dudes, DaVinci Resolve databases can be tricky things to move around. So today in this video, I'm going to show you a bulletproof, super safe and easy way to backup, move and restore your Resolve databases. So let's jump straight into Resolve. Okay, while Resolve is loading, the most important thing that you'll need is a portable drive. I like this Angelbird SSD because I know if I shift my database onto this drive and I have a complete system failure, then I have a data recovery service with Angelbird to get my database back. In saying that, you should duplicate this drive immediately using a program like Hedge for Mac or a similar program for a PC. Hedge for Mac will transfer the database and checksum it all at the same time, which is why I use Hedge for Mac for all of my database duplications. Now that Resolve is loaded, we're presented with this screen. And this is actually where we're going to generate our database backup. Now, if you're not in the practice of saving individual projects by generating separate DRX files, XMLs or EDLs, then for extra safety, we should do this first. You can do this by opening a project, going into the media pool, right-clicking on a project timeline, choose export. I always prefer to choose EDL with audio, but that's my preference. And you will need to do this for every project in your database because it's better to be safe than sorry. Save these to your external migration disk in a separate folder. Now, to be clear, these files are not individual project archives. What we have saved are media relinking files in case something goes wrong with our master database archive process. If you wish to learn how to archive individual projects, you can check out my other video up here. Now that we've created our safety net, we can create our database backup. So up here, you will see this icon. When you hover over it, it will say backup. If you don't see this icon, click on the icon here, left of where it says projects. Click backup, select your destination, give your database a name, and hit save. Then this warning will appear, but it won't take long to create. Click backup. When completed, you will see a successful prompt appear. If your database fails, you may need to format your disk to match your appropriate system's filing structure. Now you can eject your drive and move it to another computer. So let's do that. Let's load Resolve 17, but this time we're going to click Restore Database here. Now find your database in your external drive. Make sure the type selected is disk. Now, the confusing part here is that Resolve asks you to name the database, even though we've already done that when creating it. Name the database, and I'm going to call mine the same thing, Cinechimp Master. Then select your location. Now, this should be your computer's system disk. Resolve will behave very strangely if you do not use your system disk. Choose Create. Click Restore. Once it loads in the database, you will see it appear here on the left of the screen. Select your imported database and you're just off to the races. Now, it goes without saying that you will need to connect your hard drives to see the actual project files, so wherever your media is stored or has been copied to. This must be connected to the system. This is why it's important to create those EDLs and DRX files before beginning this process, in case something just goes horribly wrong. Or if you're going to be opening this database on somebody else's system where the name drives may change. For example, your main drive may be something like this, but your editor may want an NVMe or a drive to copy the files onto for their own system, which could mean that you well may need to relink all of the media for each project. Again, this is why we created the EDLs at the start, just in case. It's always best practice to make and take as many reference points of your system and project files when it comes to databases, especially when you're moving them from outside of your own system, which if you are doing, you will need to either transport your drives or take a complete copy of the media pool with you to actually work on any of the database projects. But look guys, it really is that simple. If you need to know how to relink media files, you can watch my other video up here. Hit me up in the comments if you get stuck or if you have any problems. I do actually respond to all the questions asked. And with that one, see you in the next one.